Soon. For those who are wondering, we do have another Fnatic match coming up next. They will be playing Tinker. Following that, probably the highlight of today, Na'Vi versus Secret. They have played once or twice before with the new rosters, but always good to see that grudge match, if you will. Then Cloud9 versus PR, Tinker versus Secret, and not sure why Tinker versus Secret is showing up twice on the schedule graphic at different times, but yeah, they only play once. It's a single round robin. So, all right, here we go. We're going to have Ace, for the time being, making a move with an early Observer Ward, and it looks like Ani will trot bottom, pull to Tango towards the mid lane, I believe. Yeah, they've given a little bit of regen here to Arise. We'll have to see how these dual lanes work out, but again, my question is, like, what are you doing to this offlane Tidehunter right now? Running a Centaur, Tiny dual lane. Tiny has a ton of nuke damage, but not early on. He needs his levels to get that, and it's gonna be like a guaranteed level 6 if they run dual lanes here. Death Prophet mid against a Magnus mid lane. That should be a pretty even lane in terms of farm. Give Death Prophet the edge in harassment, but Magnus can still just keep on spamming the Shockwave with the double rune spawn. Well, normally you're likely to get a rune, but when your roamers are this level dependent, in the case of the Tiny, doesn't get too much, so he may have to bottle crow a little more often, which obviously is not as strong in this version. The Batrider offlane should do okay. The Ogre to back him up. They're gonna try to engage a level 1, they'll find Goblack. This will be a great start. They skilled up Sticky Napalm. Goblack in all kinds of trouble. Hasn't even bothered to skill an ability. Continues to get harassed. The Ogre clubbing him. Oh, the concussive shot flies out. They need like two more auto attacks here. Maybe just one will do it if the Napalm doesn't wear off. Goblack still retreating. The long range lob from Ogre. He dives the tower. Goblack's gonna go down. Oh, that commitment to the cause. They needed that first blood too. I was not feeling very good about their lanes early on, but after that, that could turn things around. It's supposed to take the long journey back, though, and meanwhile, Ryze is going to be pursued and harassed out a bit by Illidan.
Not for you!
So they're running a tiny farmer, they're running a four-position Centaur for now. It looks like Ace might finally get caught off the long journey. Not looking like it's going to pay off here. He does have the boots. Can Venge stay in range? Needs one more magic missile. Doesn't quite have it. Ace doesn't have Firefly, though. They're going to be a wraparound. No? DK Phobos? Okay, they're going to cut him off with Goblack. No, but they're backing off on the side of Lil. Alright, they got him. Jesus. Man, they had to work for that. I think they're like, hey, Phobos, we might need your help, buddy. He's like, nah, I don't want to miss CS, man. This is such an easy lane for me. Yeah, this lane's going to be really easy for Tide. Mid lane, early bottle out for Arise, so he should do fine here. The supports did make a long journey off this top lane. Still, the early level's not too much they can do to Medusa. They don't yet have a pointed Firefly. Arise has hit level 2, which is pretty nice. Come with me, try to harass DK Phobos here, but this is not a battle Centaur's going to win. Even in a 1v1, he'll struggle, let alone in a 2v1. They're not going to try to make their go top lane, though. They get the stun out from Arise. There's no Firefly. With the Firefly, this would probably be a kill. But unfortunately, they just don't have it. They're still going to try to harass Illidan down. Are they committing to this? No more mana on Ryze, and Illidan should be okay. Now they turn around with Goblack. Concussive shot to go on Ace, but there's no Arcane Bolt yet. So really not too much they can do here. They'll back off. They almost found another opening, though. Well, that would have been a really big kill if only Batrider was level 2. So yeah, Hani actually doing pretty damn well here early on. He's 6-3 against the Tidehunter. That is not easy with Anchor Smash spam. It was nerfed a bit in this patch, but it's still strong against any melee hero early on. The Arise, pick up a double damage rune, and
dear me, no.
Looks like he'll be solo in this lane for now. Let's see if they bring Ryze top again. Got money for a bottle here. He could save up for those Arcane Boots or the clearly Soul Ring Rush. We have seen quite a bit of Bloodstone Ogre, normally in a core role in the American region lately, but this kind of start, you never know. For now, he's going to leave his monopole open. He may just go Arcanes, too. They have 5 pretty low monopole heroes. By the way, he's close to that first regen. The bullying continues, and well, as the laning stage settles down, it's a nice first blood there early on for Fnatic, but they gave up the return kill in the end, and the lanes don't look too good for them. Death Prophet free farming mid against the Rise Magnus. He is still doing fine, but it's not like he's winning his lane. Medusa free farming top, and Tide, of course, dominating bottom. They do have very strong roaming later on in the game. If you get your level 6 on the Centaur, you get any one of those three blinks. Good turn, but for now, it's a struggle. Hang in there if you're a Fnatic fan, because their mid-game is devastating. We definitely can see that. The Bloodlust, Empower, throw that on Tony. Tony doesn't need the most farm. Even just getting something like a Drums would be amazing. If he ever farms his Ags, he'll do a lot of work. That's kind of a big if. They have started stacking the jungle right now for him. Aside from that, nothing. It's not a huge economic boost just yet. No ancient stacks. He wouldn't be able to farm those until quite a bit later on, though. But I'm looking forward to this Arise Magnus play later on. Even though he won't have the easiest lane, he is just a sensational Magnus player. Why do teams have been banning that early on? Also, just because it seems like there's quite a bit of a drop-off from his Magnus to really any other hero. At least from the games I've watched.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
It's been a sensible ban, and it's worked out well for their opponents as of late. They did let it through. Gotting out here, top lane.
Find anything. Tower is under attack.
Ogre will rotate towards the top room, maybe even makes a jaunt towards bottom, but there is an Observer Ward protecting this. Lo continues to try to get in range, but even if he stuns Ace, they won't really have to follow. They just can't lane here very effectively, and jungle continue to be stacked. Nope, no more stacks yet. So the other issue is if this Batrider doesn't get farmed top, there's really not much waiting for him. Normally when you see teams run an offlane bat, they have one support that's stacking the camps. Sometimes it's that camp. Mid will even help them occasionally if not a rune spawn, and they're headed back to base anyway, and you expect more toss bottom lane. And then where's the follow-up? They have an avalanche. Maybe it is enough damage to kill off DK Phobos. Another anchor smash, and he's going to pop his magic stick. They need more nukes. The double edge. Does Come With Me go for this? No, not going to happen. All right, that was quite a bit of damage. But that anchor smash, like you can see all of their damage comes from nukes. That was also without him getting off a preemptive anchor smash. So some of those first auto attacks did go through. That is a pretty potent combo. Well, as I was mentioning in the draft, toss for the Centaur, it's basically a free Blink Dagger, so very nice duo. Unfortunately, they don't get the kill. Tide will walk back to base. Going to complete a magic wand. Gets a little bit of extra HP, and I like this. You see how close you were to dying? Time to get some stats. Don't just go straight regen. They may rotate their lanes a bit here. Ace is going to take over mid. At least temporarily. He may just go jungle, in fact. Yeah, they're going to bring Arise back, so they'll leave the Ogre offlane. Verizon, stacking for the Medusa at all? Let's... No stacks for her, so their supports, to be honest, haven't done too much. We'll get stunned top lane. They need that magic missile follow from Lil. He does have the boots online. We'll let them fly with the follow from Illidan. That will be a kill. Ogre down, not tanky enough here. The real worry for me for Fnatic is DK Phobos is about to hit 6, and he could easily pick up a double kill bottom. Already the level 3 anchor smash. They gotta be careful. They're gonna most likely have to send Come With Me healing. Or does he have his tranquil boots yet? No, just the boots. That's unfortunate. I almost want to say they should consider giving him the lane, but basically too late now. That will start jungling. DK Phobos. Gonna walk right by a Radiant Courier. Come With Me. I think he wants to pass this ward back. He might... Oh, there's no points he got yet. Yeah, he'll be okay. Otherwise, he might be dead to that Tide. So I gotta say, all things considered, this is pretty good for Fnatic in the laning stage. Considering their draft, they're expected to heavily lose the lanes. They got the first blood. They've got let the Batrider into the jungle. He's getting his levels. He hits level 5. Ogre not dying too much in the offlane. Level 4 already, and experience actually quite good for them, as you can see. The supports of VP obviously securing more farm for their cores, but really much beyond that. I'd like to see them either just start ganking or start stacking more for the Medusa. Something that she can farm later on. Tidehunter can take advantage of the Ancients as well. Get active, but it's getting to that point where it may be difficult now. Arise, rushing the Blink Dagger it looks like. Gonna skip those Arcane Boots as Hani did go for some early. He's hit level 6. We'll have a skirmish over the top rune. Ryze gonna snap up a regen. Not much of a skirmish when they just run away. Still waiting for this jump in from Come With Me bottom. No stampede, of course, but the Avatoss, or sorry, the toss stomp and then into the avalanche. Here, free Blink Dagger initiation. We'll get bloody soon enough, though. Goblek starts to make his move around through the river. Blink soon. Ace is rushing his as well. No bottle, no tranquil boots. If they just rush these blinks and they're allowed to get them uncontested, maybe that's enough just to pull them through the laning stage. Because at that point, you've got like a guaranteed jump in with the lasso. Stampede might even be ready, so you have like a pseudo blink dagger there. The toss initiation I mentioned. These are squishy heroes. Skywrath Mage, even a Death Prophet. Oh, there you go. Arise with the jump in mid lane. Skewer's back scandal, and Ani was waiting with the Avalanche toss combination. Nice kill there on the Death Prophet. Right before Scandal starts to build the survivability items. He's already gone for the casual bracer, but probably will build this into a drums, and from there the Yules, so. Time to kill him off. Back of that, Arise pretty much has his blink. Nadic really getting away with a support centaur. The quad melee core against the Tidehunter. It seems so far they are. Avalanche DK Phobos here, but he's hit level 6, so you now enter the danger zone if you're Fnatic. Still have to be worried about going on this Tide. No real way to deal with the Kraken Shell. No Chronosphere, no Black Hole, no Doom. They'll toss in bottom, though. They get the level 3 double edge off, but Ravage will turn this around. A Ravage for a Centaur support. Not the worst thing in the world for Fnatic here. BP will take that kill. I almost feel like Fnatic knew that might happen. Yeah, toss him in. Maybe he dies, but they're going to have to blow Ravage. You can see Hani was running away instantly. Seems like a good trade to me, so I'm guessing they said, you know what, let's just get this Ravage off the board. Now we can get aggressive. We have our Blink Dagger. RP will be ready soon. On Arise, Blink Dagger on Batrider is up. And they won't have a Ravage to counter-initiate. So if they go for two solid ganks right now and Tide can't do anything, then more than worth it. Ravage out of all those ultimates has by far the longest cooldown. Gonna rotate the Tide now to the jungle, so he'll start farming up the neutrals. So DK Phobos and Scandal working together. They do feel a bit unsafe right now as the mid tower gets denied. They have this one observer ward, but this is that time where Batrider's been off the map for a while, probably as his blink and is smoked. You really just don't want to expose your Death Prophet. So they're gonna show Goblek Mint, not the target you really want to be blowing a lasso or RP on. It's a good adjustment here from VP Polar, and it might allow them to dodge the big gank, but if they lose the Medusa instead, that's even worse. And Helene gets pulled in. He didn't manage to get off his ultimate. An instant jump from the bat. Your double edge follow-up secures the kill. Support Ogre. Support Centaur. The Bruisers combining here for a nice kill in the top lane. That's a much-needed frag. Honestly, man. This is about as good as it gets. They are down 3,000 gold, but part of that is this tower that got denied mid. No towers having yet been taken by Fnatic, and well, they are getting outfarmed heavily. But with the Blink Daggers online, they can continue to be aggressive now. They should be. Well, showing himself top. They're about to make their move in, but drawing a line in a different direction. Goblek also spotted out in the woods. And while that's happening, there's a mid jump in mid. That's the one that... A mid jump in mid, and your mid is gonna, it's gonna die. Jesus, done on to come with me. But Papa Stogaze gets swapped back in. They're trying to get him to face that Medusa, but it doesn't quite happen. Gets off the two hero stomp. Great footwork from the lumbering centaurs. Make his way out safely. So another kill mid on the Death Prophet. She is still at 84 CS, so still your most farmed hero after that Medusa. But what do you expect? The Arise Mag fishing for the skewer back to the tower. Not going to find it, but that's okay. I'll just retreat out safely. Throws out a shockwave. Might even continue chasing Lil. You have to be a bit cautious, though, with no bottle charges left.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Of course, this is leaving bottom lane unattended, and what's really going to make things harder for them is the mech going on DK Phobos. With this, you go in for those jumps, you skewer back. We've seen the Death Prophet still takes a pretty long time to kill. With the completed drum scandal, well into the four-digit HP territory. And obviously Medusa with Mana Shield, same thing. So, it gives them time to TP in the Tide and quite likely turn these fights. The other thing that I'm a bit worried about is that they don't really have a great solution for the Mana Shield. We've seen teams lately, when they give away Medusa, either they just crush them incredibly hard in the laning stage, Or they pick heroes that have mono burn. Anti-Mage, sometimes building Diffusal Blade, although it's not that effective. Getting a Necro 3 is a great strat against the Medusa. I think I even saw a Nyx Assassin or two. Though that hero's not very popular lately, but they have no mono burn at all, so they gotta fight through a very BP Medusa. Eventually, that means you blow a lot of one-time usage spells, long cooldowns, and may not have follow-up. It's an Exorcism buff. I almost feel it was unneeded by Scandal. I'm gonna keep on pushing this. This could set up nicely for a Ryze, though. Horn is waiting. Waiting too long, though. Polar will just walk away.
New treasures.
They got a tower for an Exorcism. That is two towers down, and that is another issue for Fnatic. They don't really push right now. They have Tiny with a Midas and Arcane Boots, so very little attack speed. Well, he's got okay attack speed for Midas, but really not much attack speed for him. Certainly not like the Treads into Midas build would give you. Don't really have much to damage a tower aside from Toss. Which is not bad. Lasso insta-split. Or insta-cancel, I should say. Well played there. Lil was just waiting. They knew that the lasso was likely to come, and Fnatic, oh, they blow it top, or mid, but now they're gonna try to make up for that top. They rotate come with me, and they don't have a stampede. That was already used. They'll pop the stone gaze. Ryze running around in circles. Don't face the ugly lady. Doesn't matter. They'll die anyway. They'll bring in a Ryze, though. The Magnus is there, skewering back Illidan. But there's a Rabbit waiting. There's a mech waiting. Oh, it's too late. Just a few seconds short. Oh, he almost had it. And out pops the stick charges, and yeah, he went for the early Ravage there. Didn't get off the mech. And then he did have stick charges, but she was already dead, so didn't really see much of a point to using it. They do know RP's down, though. They know Lasso's on cooldown. They know Stampede's on cooldown. And they know these two heroes are dead. It's still, in the end, a 2-for-1. Not a bad trade at all. But it feels like if they'd been just a half second quicker, they could have even saved the Medusa, gotten a clean 2-for-0, and taken down this tower top. Gonna push in the top lane. Exorcism up in 20. They might even go for 2, honestly. The only thing that would discourage that is the lack of Ravage right now. So maybe you just take the tier 1 back off and low roll it. Your Medusa is a bit too squishy to really join these fights. And doesn't have a core item anyway. Still the ultimate orb to be worked on. See. That mech advantage. Fnatic are going to have to chew through. This is a tough VP polar. They smoke. They did it like almost in vision of Fnatic. We're not stampeding their way forward, but which way do they go? They tried to jump in top, but Ace got sounds before he could get off his lasso. Instead, they turn back for Godlike. They'll finish off the Scarlet Mage. Now they'll lasso DK Phobos. He doesn't have Ravage, so they can group up on him. They can cluster on this Tide, and they will. Taking him down as well. That's a 2-for-0. Smoke pop just at the wrong time. Rip the Medusa bottom lane, though, and it's a nice gold swing. 1800. Smart turn up here for Fnatic. Finding the footing. No points in Bloodlust, yes, that will come soon. They have that first point in power. Ani's gonna get very big very quickly. He'll be working out not just in the real world, but also in Dota. Getting swole on the Tony. Might be using some performance enhancing drugs. Maybe a little steroids, but you know. Nothing that we can do about that here in Dota. How fair. He's in the game. Oh, might be enhancing, but it's allowed. You will see Ryze go for his standard follow-up to this Blink Dagger. Always the 4-staff for him. Don't ever really see him go for a BKB rush, nor, which could be an issue, to be honest. Against the Scarth Mage, that instant silence we saw can mess up the Batrider initiation, can also potentially mess up the Mag initiation. Gonna skip it. 4-staff's still a solid support item in general, and does mean that they can try to retreat out when a Ravage is coming, so I still think it has its utility, but it also means if you go for a Refresher, that's likely delayed as well. So they'll be getting double 4-staff here. Ace picking up one as well. DP have their Ravage ready again. Let's dance. Top lane, they push in. Ace still waiting. The Blink forward, got back quick on the concussive shot, but Ace even quicker on the 4-step back. Just wanted to get the Firefly down on the creep wave and slow this push. They use the Exorcism again for the tier 1. And I'm feeling like with time here with Mech Ravage, there is no way to prevent him from cracking showing. He's going to get Ravage off. You probably could have saved that for the tier 2. Is under attack. They're not even going to go for 2. They play Fnatic's game here a bit. They're going to retreat out. They'll teleport in the Vengeful Spirit, and the tower drops low mid. Glyph's ready, though. They'll stampede instantly. The second they see that first teleport, they're out. Run! They have no blink on the tide. Make their way out safely.
Dire's middle tower
mid will
been
be denied.
Denied.
That's a double... not a double deny. A deny for a deny. Instead of that usual eye for an eye. BP Polar. Clustering up near their own secret shop. They finally get the Yules and the Death Prophet. To be honest, for Scandal, not the best start. Mostly just due to those deaths. If not for that, it's been a really good game for him. He's farmed well, looking at about 6 CS a minute. A little bit less than the Lady Gorgon, but still plenty strong. May look to push here again. No ultimate for the Death Prophet for some time, though. The 8 seconds, with that not ready. But a Yules is probably a confirmed kill. The Yules, they can't blink out. They can maybe force staff. If Stampede is ready, that won't work, but for the next 20 seconds, that won't be online or so.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I'll rotate towards the mid lane. Push will come bottom. Illidan and Goblek grouped up together. See Fnatic play keep away. They do have their Stampede pretty much ready, so all their spells online. They do fight into a very strong deathfall for VP.
Dire's middle tower
mainly if the tide's there. That's where things gear up. DK Polish actually isn't bottom.
Tower is under attack.
I think part of what VP Polar's banking on is that Fnatic Radiant simply don't know where he is. They've got one observer ward here. There's not too much vision on the map right now for them. They assume that tide's bottom. They're not going to try to contest it.
Power
will fall first. Tier
2
down bottom lane.
Dire's middle
teleport
tower
in.
Is under attack.
Dusa and fake a clean win there in terms of towers. It's now retreating out. We'll see Come With Me and Arise also trotting out together. Now a bounty rune picked up by Lil. Joining DK Phobos here, and it's at that point now where VP may look towards the Roshan very soon. They've got the minus armor from the Venge, they've got the Gush for it as well, and they could rush pretty quickly with the Death Prophet ultimate. There's now online. In theory, Fnatic fight really well in the pit, but maybe the farm is there. Ani's got his Ags. That's a 21-minute Ags Midas Arcane Boots. He is going to catch up. And remember, he's got Bloodlust. He's going to have Empower. Super Tiny will be reporting for duty very soon. But still no BKB, which was a pretty big item this game against likes of a Skyrath Mage, the Damage Amp from now Max Ancient Seal, and, well, not to mention the Ravage. Trot into the pit again, and we'll see Fnatic smoke. They want to fight this one. This is not an easy contest. Tidehunter lurking on the high ground with a blink, Ravage, and Roche will fall too soon. Think about a pickoff. Ace will drop an Observer. They just want to get the hell out. That'll be a Medusa Aegis online. Picking up the Blade of Alacrity as well. Towards a Yasha. Pretty standard build here for Illidan. Against a Batrider, your Lincolns is definitely a great choice, but there are still multiple force deaths to break this. Not a guaranteed get out of jail free card, that's for sure. They just, they're most likely not looking to fight. I imagine what we're going to see from Fnatic now, strategically, you're up against still the stronger 5-man for now. You've got the better ganky lineup, try to spread the map, try to go for smoke ganks, use Stampede, use the Blink Daggers and the Lasso. Figure the Blink. So Come With Me is about to get his own. So finally, Centaur, 23 minutes in, we'll get his Blink. And for those who tune in late, no, he's not that bad at Centaur. He is playing a four-position Centaur and fairly greedy draft to back him up. He's now into the trees, but can't TP out. Doesn't have a teleport scroll, and no chance of that anyway. The amount of nuke damage VP were throwing out. They're Batrider.
Dire structures are
Glyph bottom lane, always worth popping that nowadays. They're gonna actually teleport in one. It's just the Venge though. Yeah, that was not gonna happen. They're thinking about bringing the Medusa as well, but if they want to hold that, they need the tide. I think it was gonna be too late anyway. Well, 3 Empower now out on your Tiny. About 300 damage. Quite a club. I still worry if the Medusa gets big, though. As mentioned, no mono burn versus her. Their burst, their lockdown is quite good. Tiny hits hard, but somehow they're gonna have to find a way to like bait out the stone gaze and then re-engage. For now, Horizon's gonna try to skewer Illidan up onto the high ground. He'll do it. Then TP's out and faces away. Illidan's gotta get in front of him. Oh, just seconds late. Nicely played. But Illidan says, okay, I'll farm from the high ground then. My Venge will swap me down. She's got a teleport in six. No, maybe not. Okay. Save him.
Haste.
Will? No, oh, there's another spawn. Will says, let's farm this one, then I'll get you down. All right, buddy. Come back down to Earth. Doing just fine. Nothing really lost there. Ryze does try to be cute, but yeah, of course against Avenge. The amount you can achieve with something like that is fairly limited. Not to mention they can always just ferry a TP. That's too far on their side of the map for Fnatic to really contest. The Blink Dagger for Hani. Interesting choice. So he goes back for Treads. He disassembled his Arcanes earlier. Now he completes a Blink Dagger. He wants to be able to jump in and fight effectively now. And well, how many heroes can he kill? Obviously not the Medusa. Tiarath Mage is a pretty easy kill for him. The Venges as well. This could be very potent, getting a Blink this early. It does delay his late game item progression, obviously, but these backline supports are quite important. Getting off that instant silence is essential, and the defensive swap may be needed by Lil to save a hero who's been caught out in an RP. Or something along those lines. Not to mention just to break the lasso as well. We saw that earlier. It also lets you rat a little more aggressively. You don't have a Wisp to relocate you out, so this is your own personal relocation. Short distance, but normally will be good enough. Oh no, this could be bad for Illidan though. Actually, I guess Come With Me just doesn't feel confident about that jump. They have an Observer Ward up here. Not enough for them to want to jump in on the Gorgon.
Tower is under attack.
They are playing this one fairly defensively overall. They took the tier 2 mid. They're slowly and steadily gaining objectives, but not like they're choking Fnatic out. Hani's getting a lot out of his split push. The Magnus for Ryze continues to stay relevant. With the Maxim power, we'll stack some Ancients. This will probably be farmed out by Hani momentarily. A bit late on that stack. Goes later. I think this could go either way. Late game, in theory, Ogre and Centaur supports are going to bring a ton to the table, but Venge is not shabby there, and Skyrath Mage's silence, we're not going to see BKBs for a long time, so it always remains relevant this game, I would say. Unless this goes like 70 minutes, and hey, why not? Ogre Magi now with the Aghanims online, so. See some, we see the unrefined Fire Blast unlocked, the multicast be in play more so, and looking forward to seeing some big deeps from Ryze. Big at BKBs. Probably none on VP either. Death Prophet players, especially in China, have been going for a lot of BKBs lately, but not the case here. Didn't feel they needed one early, but this means that the Ogre can really pack a wallop. 7-6 your score, 27 minutes. It's still a very even game, gold and experience-wise. But both teams having great late game. I think for Fnatic, they're very happy with the state of the game, though. You look at their draft running double melee supports against the Tidehunter, running an incredibly passive early game draft, a Magnus who needs to farm his Blink, a Heine who can't really get too active early on, and they still made it work. They found some early kills, they stayed close in terms of golden experience, and they still have some towers to knock down. If they take down two dire towers, and even the tower score, they're dead even in terms of gold. They've kept up nicely, and two supports in the Venge and the Skyrath who are starting to just fall off in terms of their durability more than anything. They haven't been getting any CS. The Ogre's been given quite a bit in comparison. Ryze all the way up at 70. The VP look to make a move. They're going to smoke mid lane. I believe just out of range of this Radiant Observer.
Tis mine.
Looks like, oh, Ace is kind of scouting for it. Actually, he might have just seen it. Looks like VP Pole are not going to find anything. Yeah, he knows. He's carrying the gem as well. He's retreating. He'll blink into the trees, and no, he'll just teleport out now. Not going to be scouted out. Hyperstone up for Hani, and Fnatic are, they're closing in on their late game items. Your Ogre working towards that. Well, let's see what it's going to be. I'm thinking the Ethereal Blade may be the choice here next. Rise, we've seen that. Certainly in the American scene, E-Blade, pretty damn good against Death Prophet as well. And it's up their nuke damage, which is still probably the majority.
Dire's
top tower is under attack. By the Tidehunter, but they would have followed that one up. We'll stomp and blink away. Ready some space for his team, and you give Tony a few seconds to show your building some love. Nope, he'll crush him. Illidan gets skewered in top lane. Where's that ultimate? He needs to pop it. Doesn't have the mana for it. Illidan may end up going down with just a whimper. He swapped away. They ravage, and then they look to go back in. But if they just retreat for a ravage, and that's all they lose, it's not the worst trade. The Tiny does fall, though. Ace forced to blink into the trees. That was without Stone Gaze. You can see just how difficult it is to go on Illidan. That's a Tiny down for Ravage. Nice takedown for VP Polar. But Exorcism also deployed very far away from buildings. Means VP, no easy tier 2 take for them. Gonna have to walk in and do it the old-fashioned way with right-clicks. Did they choose to engage? That was great timing for Fnatic too. Right as the Aegis expired, they looked for the jump in. Unfortunately, that's a level 2 swap. That's enough to make the difference there.
Radiant's top tower is
taunter up the lane and shockwave it out, but still, Scandal just slowly chipping away at this tier 2. So an Illidan mid to play defense. He actually sold his ultimate orb back, maybe reconsidering his item selection. EP will be forced back, so it's essentially end of the day, a Ravage and an Exorcism for a Tiny. Tower's claim there, just a little bit of chip damage. Ace is going to get down a nice aggressive Observer ward. Spot out all that activity around the Roshan pit. Expect VP Polar to be buzzing like flies very soon. The multicast mid lane, it's enough to secure the kill on the Skyrath. Oh my goodness. The double nuke right as a little swap of the second stun hit him, while bottom lane Scandal is taking some pressure here from the bat. Really needs that Exorcism. Oh, maybe Stone Gaze will save him. Ace chased out. The fast Death Prophet, basically a max boost speeder, 521 to be exact with the jump charge. And, now that's going to wear off, but phases again, brings down the bat. Come with me blinking in. He's blinked into trouble. Now he tries to TP out. That's not going to happen, but it is creating an opening here top lane where the Tidehunter ended up falling. Doesn't have Ravage for 20, and Hani's going to start smacking buildings. Look at that damage. 400 plus, 450 it looks like. A little bit less than that with the Empower. Without the Bloodlust, without the completed Assault Caress, which is nearly online. In the end, leave a 2-for-1 there. But well worth it to get that much damage on a tower. That is the one worry for VP. Great 5-man still, but they don't split push the way that Fnatic does. They don't have the mobility. Getting close to late game. VP Polar, they've got to have a sense of urgency now. There's about to be a double RP online. Skywrath Mage and Venge will still be relevant for their spells, but will be food for the AoE of Fnatic, and Dusa and Death Prophet can definitely take this late, but you expected to jump out to an earlier lead, I feel. VP Polar were much more confident early on, but perhaps too confident, too relaxed. Brian, look for a Roshan here, and that's just respawned. Got Illidan as well as a little near the pit. They'll scout it out.
Double damage.
Radiant do a vision. They have eyes all around it. They see DK Phobos rotating down. They see Lil in the neighborhood, and they gotta have suspicions at this point. Obviously no vision into the pit, but enough around it to get a sense for what's going on. Nice pickup here if I come with me. I really like this. Going for the Vlads now. Everything is built around the Tinies. Even though they're running very unorthodox supports, they're still kind of playing it the same way you would with the Wisp, where you get the Vlads, you get things to help him hit harder, give him some attack speed. It's like several heroes doing the work of what one hero normally does. Working out pretty well. The Bloodlust to compensate for the lack of the Tether and Overcharge, and top of that, you've got the Vlads that the Wisp normally carries, and a little extra damage from Empower to boot. Illidan will march top now. Walk past some Radiant Eyes here soon. They got vision of him, but with the Aegis up, they want to go for a clean pick. They don't want to actually be forcing their way into him. club in time. Ani is just a devastating force at this point, and I have those elemental ice shards finally fixed. Been a while since they were working. When they fixed that, actually, because that was like a year plus that they did not work. One of the first items for Tinian. It was the only one for a very long time that Starladder set came along. But goody. To make their jump in here on Scandal, this will be a big pick. Get that toss initiation off. It's tough when he has Yules, though. Scandal's quick and he gets the Yules off on himself or on the Centaur, then you're gonna have to stampede just to get out safely. They continue farming. They're still down by 3k gold, but that's with two Roshans going the way of VP Polar. Not really that much of a lead. Quiet game for both teams. 6-7 was the score. Oh, I don't know. 20 minutes ago. Now it's 9-9. Courier's flying in bottom. That has a refresher orb for Arise. Remember how this mid lane started. He was quite far down on the Death Prophet, as you'd expect. He's remained down on her, but considering what he brings to the table for that 12k gold, that's sizable. Big pickup. Assuming he gets to use it, and from here you have to imagine the BKB for Arise. He's still very vulnerable to the Skywrath Mage Silence. Go for these easy pickoffs. The low-hanging fruit is Goblack bottom lane. He's a simple kill if he's caught. Catching him. Continues to just play cat and mouse here with VP Polar. It's slow. Might be boring to some, but it's effective Dota by Fnatic. I'm not 100% sold they have late game, because you are running four melee heroes against a Medusa and a Death Prophet, who normally excel there, but I think it goes either way. If you get two good RPs and Tiny's cleaving you, that's game. You're not winning against that, and this Tony is going to have way more than 50% the bonus damage. Like, just from the Empower alone, he's adding about half to his damage, so yeah, 150% the normal right click, and then on top of that, you've got Assault Crest Worker. They're going to lasso bottom lane Stampede to drag out like a bit farther back and point breaking him in, but he yules and we'll retreat. Oh, it's a Stampede blown, a lasso forced out. Fnatic will just want to split push now. Hopefully send someone trotting top ASAP. They want to avoid that fight for around a minute or so. Be able to do it. It may be an opening for VP to threaten high ground a little bit. Threaten high ground too much. You're baiting in that double RP. You better be ready for... Well, you can't swap everyone out, so you better not get more than one or two heroes caught, that's for sure. Come with me, thrown up in the air, mid lane, and do they Mystic Flare for- Oh, camera, please. Mouse took on the life of its own. Yeah, they're gonna push Radiant in. They'll look for the tier 3 top here. Or tier 3 mid. This is them deployed, the glyph was used, Ryze walking in, looking for those multi-GG casts, but not getting any. Actually pretty damn unlikely to get enough, no multicast at all. VP will clear out the wave though, and you're gonna have to go soon. If you're Fnatic, they'll jump it with the Tiny to start. Hani's gonna BKB and just try to go to work here, but the Medusa ultimate will pretty much counter his own BKB. There's a Stampede ready to follow this up. VP Polar looking to retreat now, but Ace is gonna pursue. Force Staff ready. He could blink in momentarily. They're probably losing the Venge for this, although she could swap. Don't want to risk it. All right. Easy tier 3 mid, and melee racks will regen, but take some permanent damage here on the ranged. And the 10-second BKB from Hani forced out. And that is kind of what I mean. If VP spread out nicely, if you have like the Death Prophet and Medusa, you know, somewhere up in this front vicinity, but you just leave the Tidehunter, the Venge, and the Scarlet back, there's at most a 1 hero RP, maybe 2. And then Venge can just swap one of those heroes out. So it's like you need that, and then you also need a Ryze to get a good skewer to bring them out of swap range, and then maybe the second RP and second skewer. But obviously, that getting that many spells off and without VP Polar interrupting is easier said than done. VP may look to go mid again. Still nothing really used up by Fnatic aside from that one BKB charge. getting aggressive here. Ryze in the front line. He's looking for a stun. Tiny comes out from the tree line. Goblack caught out and just dealt with by Fnatic. That's an easy kill. That's what I mean with the Skywrath. He is very squishy at this stage. One multicast, he's dead. One tiny combo and a right click, he's dead. Goblack has to be pristine with his positioning. Simply cannot get caught out. Actually, it wasn't immaculate there, so he'll pay the price. This could help if they want to fight soon. That's a double damage rune on Illidan. The 3,400 gold. I wonder what he's going to go for next. Normally that stage where you start thinking about a rapier if you're a Medusa. Maybe one more survivability item. Bonus HP. Could go for the Eye of Scotty, perhaps, but I think we might head towards that territory soon. Scandal still has quite a bit of room here. He's only sitting at 18,000 net worth, which is good farm, but has room to pick up that late-game refresher if you want to drop it on the stash. Can care a BKB for himself at some point. Could just tank up more with a Shiva's Guard, additional armor. Always going to be nice against this Tiny. See, bottom lane, they set up on the Medusa. They ain't going on that. Not on to Illidan here. He's got who knows how many heroes back here. No eyes behind that tower, and just such a dangerous jump in any case. And what started as looked to be a pretty action-packed mid-game is evolved into a very patient late game. Best match here from Fnatic and VP. VP Polar, I should say. Set up bottom lane, they're gonna start clubbing onto Illidan. He'll pop his stone gates to try and force them out. Now the Batrider jumps in, gets thrown up in the air by the eels, did not BKB, but still manages to drag Illidan a bit farther back. Now retreating to swap back in. They look to engage on the Tony. Scandal's gonna start doing a lot of damage to him. Well, that happens, the multicast, not enough to bring him down. RP number one was used. Scandal dropping fairly low, but he gets the kill first. The Tiny lacking that follow-up damage to secure the kill, and now they gotta run the hell away. There's still a Ravage online. Arise will refresh just to retreat farther with an additional skewer. Huh. Does he not have buyback? Oh, he doesn't have buyback. Okay. Well, that makes sense then with Arise. Yeah, obviously, you don't want to wait. Tidehunter, a hero like Tidehunter, you could just Ravage, refresh, and you're pretty much not wasting your refresher cooldown. It's like a 30-second discrepancy. But with Mag, that's an 85-second difference. So you do not want to refresh unless you know you're going to be able to use the double refresher, or unless there's another reason you have to use it. In that case, he needed that extra skewer to get out. So I think that was the right choice. If he dies without buyback, that could just be checkmate straight up. See, VP have the late-game damage output. Fnatic are going to need a better RP. Or better pickoff to start the fight. Swap in here. Lil tries to initiate on Ryze, but he's a tanky support. I don't know if they really want to be forcing it on him too much. We'll go up to the high ground. RP number two is online. No Tiny for 17. He does not want to be buying back. They may just have to sack the mid-racks. Fnatic going with what looked like the ultimate Tiny late-game. Well, close to it for not having a Wisp anyway. They're the ones getting out late game right now. VP Polar slowly working on the tower here. Scandal will get stunned to start, but the racks actually, not the tower, will fall. The melee racks down, the range racks to boot. Gold still even. 3,000 gold lead for the Dire, 1,000 experience lead for the Radiant. But the big deal is the racks this game. You have a Tiny who demolishes buildings in a base race, but he doesn't have a Wisp to relocate him. He's got to run up lanes. No boots of travel for Hani. Got to do it the hard way. VP Polars, think about a jump. Come with me, he's in the woods here. No vision on him, but they're just hoping somebody walks up this hill. Then some illusions for the Death Prophet top. That will de-push this. Buy them time. And is up? Oh, no. Oh, you give this team an Aegis. That just might be too much. Not actually sure how long it's been since the next part, but I think it's towards the middle of when it could respawn. Fnatic just not feeling very confident to contest. That Rosh fall, it goes to someone. Yeah, it's a Scandal. He's was picked up by the Medusa. Is she actually the tankier one? I guess she is now with the completed Eye of Scotty. The only issue with Aegis is it's not really a great item on Death Prophet. Because of the way the ghosts work. If you die, well, you don't get those back, but you can always save the ghosts for the second life. Whereas Medusa uses her entire mana shield a bit better, but she's pretty much serves the same function. As long as she gets to pop it in. Does have that Venge back her up. BP Polar gonna force it now, though. It's only 20 kills at 44 minutes. We could see like 20 more in the next 5. If Fnatic force this fight, and they're gonna have no choice but to do it. Connie's gone in for the Daedalus. He's picked up some big damage, but the lasso instantly canceled. There's just no solution for that one. Now they go in with an RP. Arise found two. It's Illidan, number one. Now the silence comes out. He's stone gazed. He's unable to get out. Oh, the Lady Medusa, too strong. Now dealing easily with Hani. They just can't fight against her. She's healthy. Scandal's fine as well. She's still available for Illidan. Oh my goodness, RP number two. Perfect mag play from Arise, but what does it matter? So late game with an Ogre, a Tiny, a Magnus. You have a Super Tony on your hands, and he just doesn't get the job done. Can't fight into the Stone Gaze. I think looking at how this fight's developed, Fnatic, seems clear that their only way to win these fights was with a clean pick, but those were just not available. Lil was ready with the swaps. With Cheese Aegis, I don't even know if that lasso would have been good enough, unless it drew all of VP Polar into a compromising position. They're close now. VP Polar already 3-1 in the Summit 2. On the verge of a 4-1 start, and Fnatic, who started out hot 2-0, are now in danger of dropping to 2-3. That would put them not out of the running by any means. You only have to be top 40 to the playoffs, but does make the road quite a bit tougher for them. There's a go in top lane from the Batrider. Looking for your Tidehunter here. Doesn't have Refresher up yet. They're going to commit with the Tony a bit as well. While that's happening, Ryze tries to stampede away to safety. It looks like he'll be successful. Scandal also on the hunt, searching for a Yule Scepter initiation. Ryze will make his way out. The Refresher for the Death Prophet, though. Scandal with the Aegis and the double ultimate. By the time he gets to the base, he will have two ults. So he can ult once, can die, come back to life, refresh, ult again. Just look to GG it. Any chance Fnatic holds this? Not liking their chances now. That's for damn sure. Tiny just doesn't get to right-click in these fights, and it seems Fnatic, while they would like to base race, they can't do it anymore. You're down 2 racks against the Death Prophet with the Refresher. She will kill all your buildings, fight her way through the glyph, and just try out in the game if they want to commit to that before Tiny can get too close. Dire Glyph is still ready as well. Ani will do his best to take a page out of Aerosol book and base crate, stall the game late. But they don't have that tricksy Nature's Prophet at their side. Really have anything to compliment him when he split pushes. A lot of pressure on him too. Jam up on Lil here. Oh, Ani's got to be careful not to get caught out. He does not have buyback. Wave of Terror actually just scouted him. They get in range. They've got no only level 2 swap. Lil was searching though, and while that's happening, they're gonna make their jump in. This is their move. Mid lane on to Scandal, let's go. He has the Aegis though, and the double ultimate. Not an easy kill. They gotta focus this Death Prophet. The Aegis is down, but they still look to engage. The Stone Gaze caught out too. Come with me. Hani dropping quickly. RP is deployed, but the defensive swap buys a bit of time for Goblin, who Mystic Flares, shutting down Arise for now. Ravage thrown out though, and that's it. All over. Red Rover. Fnatic lose 4. Make it a 5-man wipe. They'll buy back on their Ogre, but that's just your first Death Prophet ultimate. Tidehunter, I think even has the Refresher coming. Let's see. Oh no, actually just the Tally of Evasion. They're not holding this from here. Fnatic will take another loss on the Summit too. And remember, with those increased buyback timers, or cooldowns, these heroes will not have buyback for a very long time. Ryze, stunned up, brought down, another kill. A wipe and then a plus one as VP Polar take this first game. It was 47 minutes, but they had full faith in their game plan, and it seems Fnatic, maybe theirs was a bit misplaced, trying to just go late game against Medusa Death Prophet. No answer for the defensive swaps, no answer for the counter-initiating ravages, and casual BM basher picked up by the Medusa as the game ends. Great start there for VP Polar in our opening match of the day. We'll see more Fnatic, though. They're coming right back, and they will be playing Tinker. Tinker streaking as of late. They've been looking very strong in pretty much every league. They're already 3-0, our first undefeated team to get to 3 games here in the Summit, too. Well, great start for them overall. And with that said, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to wrap things up. You can see here on the scoreboard, ta-da, great win for VP Polar. They are now 3-1 in the Summit 2. Of course, I'm LD. We'll return momentarily for our next match. That will be Tinker versus Fnatic. And I think I'm going to try to wake up Merlini. The 6:30 game is a bit early for him. We'll see if we have a co-caster for game number 2. Thanks for watching the Summit 2 by G2A.com. We shall be right back.